In this video, we're going to talk about how computer graphics work. Or really, how computer graphics used to work back in the 1990s, when everything was two-dimensional. Nowadays, things are a lot slicker, but the same ideas that applied then apply now only in three or four dimensions. Okay, so our first goal, is to come up with a way to take some object and either rotate it or stretch it or reflect it or move it around. That's two-dimensional objects working in the two-dimensional plane. Now, the simplest case of that is when everything sits at the origin and you don't need to move things around. In that case, you can do everything using 2x2 matrices, the really linear transformations of the plane to itself. So you represent the position of something by x, y, make a 2-vector out of it, and you're going to act on that 2-vector with a 2x2 matrix. Now, in our last video, we talked about how rotation by an angle theta is described by this 2x2 matrix. Because when you rotate E1, you rotate 1, 0, you get cosine theta sine theta. And when you rotate 0, 1, you get minus sine theta cosine theta. And the matrix of linear transformation is always what happens to E1, what happens to E2. Okay, so that's a pure rotation. And here's a picture of what happens. You know, we're thinking of the origin as being in the middle of the nose, and you just rotate the whole thing by some angle, and the origin is still in the middle of the nose. And you apply this matrix to every point in that face, and you change this face to this face. Okay, the next thing you might want to do is stretch things. Now, of course, you can stretch things by any factor you want, but let's talk about stretching things horizontally by a factor of 2, just pulling things out. So if you stretch the vector 1, 0 by a factor of 2, you get 2, 0. If you stretch the vector 0, 1 by a factor of 2, well, you're stretching things horizontally, and it's a vertical vector. It doesn't change. It stays 0, 1. So our first column is 2, 0, second column is 0, 1. And when you multiply every point in the face by that, it just stretches everything horizontally. Now, okay, I can't draw. This looks a little bit shorter than this, but imagine that I drew it well. Okay, if you want to stretch vertically by a factor of 2, then 1, 0 becomes 1, 0 because you haven't changed, because that's a horizontal vector. But 0, 1 becomes 0, 2. So first column is 1, 0, second column is 0, 2. And that's how you take something and stretch it vertically. You can also reflect. If you want to reflect something, that's sort of like stretching it horizontally by a factor of negative 1. 1, 0 becomes negative 1, 0. But 0, 1 stays 0, 1. So we get negative 1, 0 and 0, 1. So that's how you reflect things horizontally. If you want to reflect things vertically, you just use the matrix 1, 0, 0, minus 1, because 1, 0 reflected vertically, it's still 1, 0. 0, 1 reflected vertically, it becomes 0, minus 1. Okay. Now, if you want to rotate and then stretch, you apply the two matrices one at a time. You first rotate, and then you stretch. Now, you can multiply that out, and you get a 2x2 matrix, and graphics cards are designed to multiply 2x2 matrices and 3x3 matrices and 4x4 matrices really fast. That's what a graphics card is for. So the rotate and then stretch would be represented by a 2x2 matrix that's the product of this matrix and this matrix. And what does it do? That rotates and then stretches. Now, order matters. If you stretched and then rotated, that would be a different operation. To stretch and then rotate, you would first stretch and then you'd rotate. Why is this the first guy? Because you're applying this to the vector xy. This is the original position. This is the stretched position. This is the stretched and rotated position. And what does that do? If you stretch and then rotate, it's not the same thing as rotating and then stretching. Okay, so order matters. Now, so far, we haven't moved anything around. If you want to move things around, then you have to represent things not as two vectors, but as three vectors. You put in this extra entry of a 1. You represent a position as x, y, 1. And everything that we did so far, you just use the same 2x2 matrix that we worked out before, and you pad it with 0, 0, 1, 0, 0. Because if you multiply that by x, y, 1, what you wind up with is 2x2 matrix times x, y, and then a 1. The 1 comes along for the ride. Nothing happens with the 1. Now, if you want to move things around, you use this 3x3 matrix. That's where these entries come in. They have to do with moving things around. Because if you do this and you multiply by x, y, 1, well, let's see, the first entry is 1 times x plus 0 times y plus h times 1. That's x plus h. Second entry is 0x plus 1y plus k. And the third entry is 1. So this is the matrix that just takes every vector and moves it over by hk. And now we can figure out how to do things, more complicated things. So suppose you wanted to rotate around the point 2, 1. You've got this face sitting at 2, 1, and you want to rotate around this point. You don't want to rotate around the origin, or else you'll get a face that's sitting over here. You want to rotate around 2, 1. And you do it in stages. You're going to first move it to the origin, and then rotate it around the origin, and then move it back. So how do you move it to the origin? Well, you have to move by negative 2, negative 1. How do you rotate? You get cos theta, sine theta, minus sine theta, cos theta, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0. And how do you move from the origin to the point? To 1 with that matrix. So to do the whole compound thing, you have to first move to the origin, then rotate, and then move back. And you have to figure out what is the product of these three 3x3 matrices. Again, your graphics card is really good at multiplying 3x3 matrices. It'll do that in an instant. It'll figure out this big matrix whose whole job is to rotate things around the point 2, 1. If you wanted to reflect around the point 2, 1, you would have just had a reflection matrix instead of a rotation matrix here. And that's it. Now, what's the difference between that and a modern thing? Well, a modern computer really does things in three dimensions and also has perspective. You know, it allows things to shrink and grow as you get closer and farther away. That basically boils down to using two extra dimensions. So you wind up with 4x4 matrices and sometimes 5x5 matrices. But the basic ideas are still the same as what we did in this video.